One of the pillars of programs at the garden is to explore the intersection of art and nature. So we've worked with Chihuly, for example, other artists that have done sculptural installations here at the garden. And the wonderful thing about that intersection of art and nature is that each enriches the other. So when we had the chance to work with ballet and to do a visual performance here at the garden, playing on our strength, the plants and the landforms, the landscape, with the strengths of the ballet, the beauty and the athleticism of the dancers and the genius of Eve Andersen's creations, it just seemed like a perfect match for the two organizations.
And up, two, go, two.
I'm hoping that, you know, with being outside, you already have so much. It will give the audience something, a different, different sense, different feeling from the very beginning. Chuck, Chuck. It's kind of funny, actually.
We've performed outside before, but I think what's going to be really special about the garden, the botanical gardens, is that just the atmosphere and having the mountains in the background, the sunset, the colors of the flowers, and just the dancing and the music that E picked is beautiful. So I think the whole thing together is just going to be an amazing experience.
So I'm very interested in going to the desert, standing there, listening to beautiful music, moving to beautiful music, and this is really cool. I'm very, very, very excited to be a part of it.
I told my parents, and my mom is crazy about it, and I know that if she thinks it's, you know, the best thing ever, and she has to fly from Houston to see it, she said, that I know that everyone in the valley that gets the notice or that knows about it, I think they're gonna be thrilled.
1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 8. Up, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2.
We're in a studio that maxes out at about 45 feet wide. So when we're rehearsing it in the rehearsal space, we have to just sort of imagine that we're farther away from each other.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4.
So, but since you're gonna be on the other stage.
Yes.
So I don't know how the hell are we gonna do this?
So we've actually moved out into the parking lot and kind of did a rough draft of what it was going to be like out there, and that was kind of interesting. Put the music in the car, open the car windows, and so that was kind of fun.
No, let's go from the beginning. Okay.
It's been kind of hard to see it since we don't have the space right now in the studio. So that day that we got to go out in the parking lot and we ran it, we measured out the length of the stage. After that rehearsal, I could see where his vision was, where everything was going, where it was supposed to be placed, kind of the mathematics, the grid, the outline of it.
Even further over and go through.
So it was actually really nice going out there and trying to improvise and figure out, and I think it's going to be a very, very interesting piece.
Yeah, you need to be. Wait. 5, 6, 7, 8, and go.
I've never rehearsed in a parking lot. It all, you know, comes together to be fun creating art rather than work creating art.
All right. Thanks. Good. 5.
There was a lot of buzz recently when the dancers left the studio and went out into the parking lot to do a rehearsal. I did see the expressions on the dancers' faces when they were coming back into the building. and you could just tell from their faces that they were completely into what they were doing, really enjoying the experience.
Super fast.
Tell me what you want.
Splatter, splatter, splatter. They should look like aboriginals.
Okay.
Sort of different colors, but like really like mud.
Okay.
This is all water-based or what?
Yes, this is.
Have you been to the bathroom?
I felt terrible for you.
Oh, it's a dream.
You bastard.
All right. Oh.
So if we shoot at F11, we'll have a background that is lowish.
Just look at these aboriginals.
Oh, wow.
What do you think? Do you think we should have more, or should we keep it like that and then...
Let's see how that shoots.
See how it shoots.
Yeah, perfect.
Ready?
Today was a day that was really exciting, and we were looking forward to it for a long time. A lot of times in a photo shoot, when Eve's creating a new work, more of the inspiration and the story comes out in the actual photo shoot.
No, if anything, it should be sort of like that way.
Mm-hmm. One, two, three.
Another purpose of the photo shoot was to invite John Salat and Renee from the garden.
That would be a perfect cover right there.
We were looking for an image that would work on the cover of the Desert Botanical Gardens quarterly magazine.
Bottom of the masthead down, it's 9 1/4.
So 9 1/4, 8 1/2. Thank you.
We went over there really looking for some great pictures that will tell the story. Everything we do is about telling the story so people are interested in buying tickets. So that really helped. It was a fun collaborative morning, and you know, to see this come to life.